one of the most influential composers of the 20th century was a composer by the name of Igor Stravinsky. He was born in 1882 in Russia. Igor's father was a bass singer at the Mariinsky Theater in St. Petersburg, and he pushed his son to begin piano lessons at a young age. By the age of 15, Igor Stravinsky mastered Mendelssohn's Piano Concerto in G minor. Stravinsky studied law at the University of St. Petersburg, but his passion was music. Igor studied music from a renowned composer at the time by the name of Rimsky-Korsakov. Stravinsky's career was noted for his stylistic diversity. He achieved international fame when he composed three ballets, which include The Firebird in 1910, which you hear in the background, from the movie Fantasia, Perchichka in 1911, and The Rite of Spring in 1913. During the 1920s, his work took on traditional musical forms of concerto, grosso, fugue, and symphony styles. The Firebird premiered in Paris on June 25, 1910, at which time he became an overnight sensation. After many travels throughout France and Switzerland, he arrived in New York City in September 1939, where he finally settled down in Los Angeles and became a United States citizen on March 9, 1940. Stravinsky was on the site of Paramount Pictures during the recording of The Court Jester, and as he walked in, everyone stopped what they were doing and was intrigued by his presence. This was the beginning of his unknowingly composing songs for many motion picture movies that have intrigued the filmmakers of the 20th century. Many of Stravinsky's works, or parts of his works, have been and still are used in movies today, such as The Rite of Spring in Rise of the Guardians, which you are hearing now in the background, and also The Firebird in Fantasia, which you heard at the beginning of this podcast. Also, Le Secret du Printemps in Bringing Out the Dead, and his story, Du Soldat, in Waiting for a Woman in 2010, and many, many more. Igor Stravinsky died at the age of 88 on April 6, 1971, of a massive heart failure. His life will live on in infamy, as producers and writers alike will continue to use his music throughout history and throughout the entire world as well. In my opinion, this composer will be missed more than any other composer throughout history. Igor Stravinsky, you will be missed greatly, and I know you are composing today in a better place to all the angels in heaven. I want to thank you for listening to my podcast, and I hope the next time that you go to a movie theater, think of who wrote the songs in the production, and think of Igor Stravinsky.